Osama!
A moonless night, a darkened house in 2011, and SEAL Team 6 swoops down to get Osama bin Laden.
You didn't realize what you just did?
It was all captured in the hit movie Zero Dark Thirty, but now a former member of that secretive elite unit is adding a tantalizing detail.
He smacked me on the shoulder and said, "Bad guys, bad guys."
Robert O'Neill tells the Washington Post he was just behind the lead SEAL, the point man, when bin Laden appeared in an upstairs bedroom doorway. O'Neill says the point man fired and missed, bin Laden retreated, and O'Neill dove into the room to see bin Laden just behind a young woman. "In that second, I shot him 2 times in the forehead. Bap, bap. The second time, as he is going down, he crumpled to the floor in front of his bed, and I hit him again." It is similar to a version captured in the book No Easy Day by Matt Bissonnette, another member of that SEAL team. But the author makes it clear his story and O'Neill's are not the same.
Two different people telling two different stories and for two different reasons.
In Bissonnette's version, the point man hit bin Laden first, mortally wounding him. Then two other SEALs rushed in to shoot the terrorist leader as he lay on the ground, finishing him off. Officials and special operations sources have confirmed that O'Neill was on that raid and was in the room. So is it possible no one knows who fired the fatal shot?
You know, the fact that there's two different accounts to this story isn't hugely surprising. Everybody has different memories, especially when it's a fast-moving event.
The dispute has caused an uproar in military circles where some see capitalizing on such operations with fame, books, and movies like SEAL Team 6 as hypocritical, a smear on the idea of service to country.
I won't speak to the specifics on this. Some of these things are, as you know, still being investigated. But it does violate a code of ethics that this community holds dear, and 99% of them all live by that code.